On completing this section, you should have a good understanding of the operation of the ALCAP lubricating oil system. Pre-start checks. Starting sequence. Separation sequence. Discharge sequence. Stopping procedure. The pre-start checks. Check that the EPC is correctly programmed. Check that the separator is correctly assembled. Check that the system valves are in the correct position. Check the power supply. With new installations, particularly pay attention to the supply. Is the voltage and frequency correct? Switch the power on. Click the isolator on the starter box. Open EPC door by clicking on the door handle. Click on power button top left. Check the air supply. It should be 6 bar. Check the water supplies, high/low pressure. Both are required for LOPX systems. Check the brake. Is it off? All LOPX separators have a brake. Check the lubricating oil for the drive. Starting the ALCAP system. Start the feed pump from the pump starter. Start the heater from the EPC 400. Start the separator. Listen and observe. Ensure the separator is at full speed. You can now click the Alarm Accept button and step through the list indications. Now the process should be started. Push the Start Separation button to make the EPC enter the start sequence. Start of process sequence. The EPC enters the start sequence. The first stage of this is parameter 50, the closing of the bowl. Closing water is applied to the bowl. MV16 is activated. If the Alarm Accept button is pressed once at this time, the display should show the timer parameter 50 counting down according to the parameter setting. Parameter 90 has been set to 1 for this indication to be active. The oil is still recirculating through the heater. Start of process sequence. The next stage of the start of the process, parameter 52, is where the oil feed valve changes position and oil is fed to the bowl. This is a stabilizing period for the transducer. The bowl fills with oil and cleaned oil is discharged by the pairing disc. A back pressure is established in the clean oil outlet. The minimum value of this back pressure will be dependent upon the delivery height, which is usually quite low for lube oil systems. The operating back pressure is set by the regulating valve, midway between the delivery height pressure and the pressure required to overflow the bowl. The transducer reference is stored by the EPC 400 at the end of this timer. This timer runs for 120 seconds. The next stage is the addition of conditioning water, parameter 53, which helps to keep the sludge moist and thus helps with the discharge. The aim is to add a predetermined volume of water to the bowl periphery. This timer runs for a time determined by parameter 12 times parameter 70. Parameter 12 equals number of conditioning water pulses. Parameter 70 equals the length of each pulse for conditioning and displacement water. This is longer or shorter time depending on the size of your bowl. In combination with the water flow rate from solenoid MV10, a volume of water will be added to the bowl. MV10 opens, MV10A closes, and water goes into the center of the bowl under the distributing cone. Keeping the water and oil segregated as long as possible helps to minimize the risk of emulsification. Check discharge. It is considered good practice to check that the separator does discharge. This is done by pressing the discharge button on the EPC. This will be described in the discharge sequence. Discharge sequence. P60 is the time to the first discharge. Thereafter, it forms part of the total time between discharges. This is normally set to 10 minutes. Specific circumstances may dictate otherwise. Our primary objectives are no oil losses, no water in the oil, complete discharge of accumulated sludge and water. You remember that with the fuel oil ALCAP, the planned discharge after parameter 1 runs out is initiated by displacement water being added until the trigger point is reached. With a lubricating oil ALCAP, this is not the case. A predetermined quantity of water is added to displace the oil, but not enough so as to push the water into the disc stack and cause the trigger range to reach 100%. After the startup, the first discharge takes place when the timer parameter 60 runs out. Thereafter, when parameter 1, parameter 60 plus parameter 61, runs out. During parameter 60 and parameter 61, the trigger level, left side of the normal display in the EPC 400, changes by units of 1. During parameter 62 and the addition of displacement water, it changes by units of 5. The timer runs for 60 seconds. The object here is to prepare the water detection system at a time when we know water is about to be added. To achieve this sensitivity, the trigger level is multiplied by 5 at the beginning of parameter 62. This times 5 is not activated if the alarm for high water in the oil has been activated, A712. If there had not been a change in the trigger level since the last reference was stored, then its value would be 0, which when multiplied by 5 is still 0. Say there had been a small change in the trigger level since the last reference was stored, for example to a value of 4. Multiplying by 5, the trigger level display would then show 20. Remember that if at any time the trigger level reaches 100%, a discharge is initiated and bowl opening water applied. Say there had been a larger change in the trigger level since the last reference was stored and the display was showing 20. When multiplying by 5, the trigger level would be at 100 and the discharge takes place immediately. There is one other parameter I have to mention at this point, parameter 19. This is normally set to 0. There may be circumstances when this factory set constant will have to be changed. This should only be changed by an Alfa Laval representative. When parameter 19 is set to 1, the trigger level is forced to be 0 at the beginning of parameter 62. The times 5 function still applies, and the value of the trigger level goes up as the displacement water is detected. Displacement water. Now go to the next page to see in detail. Displacement water. At the beginning of every timed discharge, that is when there is extremely low free water in the oil, displacement water is added to economize on oil losses. This stage is determined initially by the values of parameter 13 and 14, factory set at 10 pulses and 2 pulses. The number of pulses is adapted by the controller depending on specific conditions. This adaptive nature will be described later. The bowl has a small quantity of conditioning water at the periphery. This water should fill in relation to the addition of the discharge water pulses. There are two conditions for the initiation of a discharge. The trigger point is reached due to water reaching the disc stack, just the same as with the fuel oil ALCAP system. This condition is now assumed to be understood. It will not be described here. Link back to discharge sequence if required. The predetermined quantity of displacement water has been added after the series of water pulses and pauses have taken place. This will be described here. The controller waits after adding some of the displacement water to see if this is enough to make the water reach the disc stack. This timer runs for 3.0 seconds. Reference time. The new stored reference value can be higher or lower than the previous reference. If at any time the actual value of the transducer moves below the stored reference, then the reference moves down with it and stays there. This timer runs for 30 seconds. A small amount of conditioning water is added to help with the next discharge. This timer runs for a period determined by parameter 70 times parameter 12. For LOPX 710 using factory settings, this equates to 50 seconds. Now go to the next page to see the details. A small amount of conditioning water is added to help with the next discharge. This timer runs for a period determined by parameter 70 times parameter 12. For a LOPX 710 using factory settings, this equates to 50 seconds. In the following pages, we will see discharge sequence in the following conditions. Normal condition, low water content in the oil. High water content in the oil. Adaptive adjustment of displacement water. The maximum time between sludge discharge depends on process conditions, and parameter 1, the time between discharge, should be set accordingly. The factory setting of this time is 30 minutes. P1 equals P60 plus P61. When this condition exists, which we would hope is most of the time, separation sequence follows discharge sequence, and this situation continues. The rolling repetition of separation, 30 minutes, followed by discharge sequence, continues 10 times. Discharges which occur during the separation sequence, parameter 60, parameter 61, parameter 62, are not counted as part of the accumulation towards the 10th discharge. It is necessary to test the system to ensure that the water which is added for displacement is actually detected by the transducer. At the 10th discharge, the trigger level must increase by a minimum of 30%. This is an extra condition applied to the 10th discharge. The displacement water at the 10th discharge is added continuously as pulses, equal to the number of pulses at the last discharge, in this case 10. A pause of 30 seconds. Two more pulses added together. If this was enough to achieve the extra condition of an increase of 30% in the trigger level display, then the system is still functioning and displacement water is still getting into the bowl. If not, then the 10th discharge is repeated a second time. This time the discharged water is added continuously for 12 pulses. A pause of 30 seconds. Two more pulses added together. If this were still not enough, then the increase is repeated again. If not, then the 10th discharge is repeated a third time. This time the discharged water is added continuously for 14 pulses. A pause of 30 seconds. Two more pulses added together. If this was still not enough, then the increase is repeated again. If not, then the 10th discharge is repeated a fourth time. This time the discharged water is added continuously for 16 pulses. A pause of 30 seconds. Two more pulses added together. If this was still not enough, then the increase is repeated again. The number of times this discharged water is increased before alarm is determined by parameter 44. When parameter 44 has been achieved, then alarm A711 is activated. The discharge counter is set to zero if the trigger level change is detected or A711 is activated. High water content in the oil. If a certain amount of free water is present in the oil, approximately equal to 0.5%, it will be separated out in the bowl, the level moving towards the disk stack to be detected by the transducer in the oil inlet. A discharge will be triggered by the EPC 400. A new reference value is then stored. If this triggering occurs before the maximum time between discharge has elapsed, parameter 1 equals parameter 60 plus parameter 61, 5 times in a row, then the alarm for high water is activated. A712. This alarm can be accepted. There is no automatic action, and A712 continues to alternate in the display. Conditioning water is not added when A712 has been activated, as it is not necessary to add any more water. Click button to accept alarm. Action should be taken to identify and rectify the source of the water increases. If the maximum time between discharge elapses without the trigger point being reached, a normal discharge will take place. The total number of displacement water pulses will be the same as there was at the last planned normal discharge, unless it is the 10th planned normal discharge, in which case total pulses will be increased by 2. The A712 alarm will be cleared if the number of pulses added is greater than P13/2. This is an ALCAP separator that can only remove water from the system by discharge. Repeated frequent discharging due to high water content in the oil is considered an unsatisfactory situation and should not be allowed to persist for long periods. Adaptive adjustment of displacement water. Remember our primary objectives. No water in the oil, no oil losses. For improved separation efficiency, the interface should be outside the disc stack. To avoid oil losses, the interface should be displaced to near the disc stack before discharge, but never into the discs. The adaptive nature of the displacement water makes it possible for the system to adjust itself to changing process conditions, such as increased water content in the oil or restricted flow of displacement water. The number of pulses at the previous discharge can be seen by stepping the alarm accept button to position 5, provided the system is not in the discharge sequence. The number of displacement water pulses is only increased at the 10th discharge. Discharges which occur during the separation sequence, parameter 60, parameter 61, parameter 62, are not counted as part of the accumulation towards the 10th discharge. The number of displacement water pulses is decreased when the following criteria is fulfilled. The trigger point was reached during the addition of displacement water, parameter 70, or during the pauses, parameter 71, at the previous discharge. What the controller has determined is that enough displacement water was added at the previous discharge. The total number of pulses will be reduced by 1. If the trigger point was reached 2 discharges in a row, then the total number of pulses will be reduced by 2. If the trigger point was reached 3 discharges in a row, then the total number of pulses will be reduced by 3. The number of pulses which are added together, without pauses, is always 2 less than the total pulses actually added at the previous discharge. For example, if 5 pulses had been added at the previous discharge and triggering was not reached then, the continuous pulses at this discharge would be 3. We will now see the last 3 steps for other situations. Click 10th discharge. Stopping sequence. This is a sequence of events which safely stops the separator. The stopping sequence is initiated by pressing the second button from the top once. The controller enters the beginning of the discharge sequence. This has already been described, unless the discharge sequence is already running. The only difference at this time is that the third LED from the top flashes yellow. This yellow LED is steady when the sludge discharge sequence is complete. Displacement water is added. This timer runs for 70 seconds. The recirculation valve has changed position. Oil is no longer supplied to the separator. Displacement water is fed into the bowl. It pushes out the oil remaining in the bowl. The separator motor is stopped. This timer runs for 180 seconds. Stop the heater from the EPC. Make sure that the oil temperature drops. The brake should be applied once the EPC displays off. Stop the feed pump at the starter. When the separator has stopped, release the brake. Restart the separator for 20 seconds to empty the bowl of remaining liquid. Close system valves as necessary.